Nako ha, mga mommies, titas at mga ate, sama na rin natin si daddy, si tito, si kuya. Goal nyo ba na mawala ang mga flabs at palitan niya ng abs? Nako ha, kung kayo ay curious dyan at bakit nga ba or ilan nga ba months dapat na mag-workout bago ito mag-progress at makapag-lose ng weight at mawala yung mga belly fats na yan. Ako, aalamin natin yan right here, right now. Pag-uusapan natin niya yung umaga. Kasama natin si Coach Ann Aniag of Fit Mom Project PH. Good morning po, Coach Ann.
Hello, good morning, Apple. Good morning din sa mga kapambansang almusal natin. Kamusta kayong lahat?
So coach, eto ha, simulan na natin. For sure marami ang curious about our topic this morning. Can you tell us po muna, bakit ba importante ang pag-exercise o pag-workout?
Ayun, thanks Apple. Tignan muna natin, what's the benefit ba of exercise? Usually kasi, naiisip natin na once you say exercise, it's like a chore. Something na kailangan mong gawin na parang it's very, kumbaga, kailangan may responsibilidad ka, kumbaga masyado siyang matrabaho. So what if, instead of thinking about it as an exercise, think about it as a lifestyle. Kumbaga, it's a healthy and active lifestyle dapat eh. So aside from thinking about, kailangan ko siyang gawin every day, di ba? What if ang tignan mo is not yung task, but think about the value na pwede mong makuha with your healthy and active lifestyle. So you have to think about the value. So kung usapang importance na lang, di ba? There's a lot of benefits ng exercise. I always tell my clients na look beyond. Na once you say na exercise, you're not just doing it as a form of lose weight or weight loss or maybe form of fitness, di ba? Mm-hmm. Once you say na it's exercise, you look beyond. You look all of the benefits after weight loss. Maraming health benefits ang exercise. You can have better mental focus. If you're currently working from home or naka-online class, naka-modules, you have better mental alertness or better productivity. You'll also have better energy. So marami talagang benefits ang exercise. It's not just like a chore. And marami talaga siyang marami siyang pwedeng makatulong din sa overall health mo. Not only sa physical, but also sa emotional, sa mental. It's really a holistic task and activity that you always need to do for the rest of your life.
Now Coach Ann, meron po bang minimum number of minutes to work out or for your workout to be considered as effective, or meron din po bang maximum?
Ayun, so thank you. Marami nagtatanong din sa akin about that. And I usually answer na it's better than no workout at all. Yun. It's always lalo sa panahon ngayon, di ba? It's most of the time we're just sitting down. Mm-hmm. You're naka-meetings, naka-online. So it's much better to always move. That's the simple word that I always advise din sa mga clients and mga friends ko na rin. Move. It's very important. So it doesn't really matter kung sa ngayon ha, especially it doesn't really matter if you're doing it, you're putting 30 minutes, 45 minutes, even 50 minutes in the gym or even at home working out, basta dapat gumagalaw ka. 20 to 30 minutes is the usual ideal talaga. Kasi kumbaga para there's a combination na nawa-warm up ka, and then nag-i-increase ang body temperature mo because you're doing the physical activity, and then you have the right amount of cool down. So although 20 to 30 minutes is the really ideal, up to 45 minutes, at the end of the day, move. It's very important. And there's a lot of ways to move. Pwede ka naman na habang nag-meeting, instead of just sitting down, why don't you put your laptop up? So mas mataas na position para nakatayo ka. Diba? Mm-hmm. And you can move around, step on the side, ganyan. So there's a lot of ways to incorporate, not just exercise like one, the typical words that we know that jumping jacks, squats, just walk. That's the simplest form of exercise also. Walk and move talaga. Yan.
Since nabanggit yun na rin po, Coach Ann, kasi yung iba, tulad ng mga mommies na katulad niyo po, alam naman natin, sobrang busy sa lahat ng kailangan nilang asikasuhin. What would be your recommended workouts or form of exercise para sa mga mommies who feel na wala silang time for it?
Ayun, I usually get that. Grabe, thank you talaga for all those. Let me also help you understand the value. Don't think about, you have to start with mindset. Okay? So once you say the word, I don't have time, di ba? No time is a very powerful sentence. Eh? No time. So start with that. Instead of saying no time, why don't you say me time? Right? So dedicate that certain amount of time. We all have 24 hours in a day. And what if you just dedicate 30 minutes up to 1 hour? O, huling tawad na yung 1 hour, di ba? So 23 hours of the day, do it for your other tasks. You can either sleep, take care of your baby, cook, ano pa ba, maglinis ng bahay. Marami nang pwedeng gawin eh. Pero spend one hour at least, or at least mga 20 to 30 minutes nga sabi ko kanina, dedicate a certain me time for yourself. Kasi it's very important. You've been generating out too much energy and too much time for your loved ones, for the people, especially sa work din or sa school, ganyan. Marami kang chances in a day na binibigay mo lahat ng energy and even time sa ibang tao. Don't forget to take care of yourself. Yun. So, what are the things that you can do? Lakad-lakad ka sa hagdan, di ba? Akit-baba ka sa hagdan. That's already worth incorporating, kung ikaw ay plantita, sino shoutout sa mga plantita dyan? Alagaan mo yung mga plants mo, kausapin mo sila, and if you're also taking care of your pets, di ba? If you can, of course, with safety, all the safety protocols, you can walk around yung dog. So marami talagang pwedeng paraan, not just yung standard na exercise na alam natin na jumping jacks tayo, sayo tayo, zumba tayo, ganun. So maraming iba't ibang paraan. Again, at the end of the day, dapat kailangan mong mag-move.
Yan. So mga kapamansahan, remember to move every day. Pero ito, coach, maraming nagtatanong nito at maraming tatamaan sa tanong na ito. May mga nagtataka, bakit daw ang tagal na nilang nag-workout, months, years, pero ang bagal daw mag-lose ng weight, lalo na yung belly fats. Is it because of the eating habits or is it because they're doing the wrong kind of workout?
Ayun, so that's good. So focus muna tayo dun sa belly fats, okay? You have to understand na yung belly fat, syempre, I always say this to my clients also, na you do not, hindi mo siya naiipon overnight, okay? So do not expect also to lose it overnight. So, process, it takes time. You just have to trust the process. Lagi ko na sinasabi yun. And aside from trusting the process, waiting for it, being patient, staying consistent, enjoy the journey din. Marami kang pwedeng gawin na, you have to think about na belly fat din. It's not just about, yun nga, gusto mo lang aesthetics, gusto mo lang magkaroon ng abs. If you try to reduce yung belly fat, okay, it goes beyond just weight loss again. Maraming benefits. Again, think about the value of losing belly fat. Maraming benefits ang pag-lose ng belly fat. Of course, mas magiging healthy ka, hindi ka masyadong hinihingal, kasi lesser yung weight na kinikarry mo every single day. So, in terms of progress naman, just don't look at the fact na, you're working out naman, you're putting in the effort on the physical activity. Take note, it's 80% nutrition and 20% exercise. At the end of the day, again, you have to fix your food. It's important kasi kahit gano'ng karaming physical activity yung nilalagay mo, okay, pinapagod mo yung katawan mo, you have to make sure that you're putting the right effort also sa food intake mo. Kasi baka mamaya, kaya hindi ka rin naglulose, di ba? Kasi nga, workout ka na workout, hindi mo naman inaayos yung kinakain mo. Kasi pagkatapos mo mag-workout, kakain ka ng sobrang high calorie, high carbohydrate breakfast or any meal. So, wala din. Na-offset mo lang yung in-effort mo, yung pinagod mo. So, you have to focus on the food. Fix your food first and then fitness follows. Yeah.
Since coach na-mention yun na about diet and food, marami din sa atin ang curious, yung no-rice diet. Is it an effective way to lose weight and at the same time, is it healthy?
Okay, so no rice diet is very controversial. Masasabi ko na talaga. And actually, as a Filipina na lang, good job sa mga kayang mag-no rice. Pero to be perfectly honest, ako po kasi, I love my rice also. It's my source of carbohydrates. Eh. It's a macronutrient. You need it for energy. So, actually, if kaya mo naman, I do believe kasi na once you say it's diet, it's not something that na dapat restrictive. Dapat, your diet should always be a well-balanced one. So dapat as much as possible, you still incorporate carbohydrates, maybe just from another source, okay? But if you still love your rice, ako, like I do, I love my rice, I still love my noodles, ganyan. So, huwag mo masyadong pahirapan, but huwag mo masyadong i-restrict yung sarili mo just to lose weight or lose that belly fat. Again, it's better also if magno-no rice ka, what if you just rotate the food intake? Rotate mo yung carbohydrates mo. There's a lot of good sources of carbohydrates aside from our white rice and our other colored rice. So, kung pwede, like for example, Monday, you can incorporate your rice, di ba? Tuesday, ganyan. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, lunch. Pwede naman na din ang gawin mo. Pwede ka maghalo ng fruits and vegetables. Those are also carbohydrates. Whole grains, pwede rin. Oats. So, maraming options na other than rice. But, again, Filipinos tayo, if you cannot live without your rice, ito lang din ang advice ko. Rice is fine, extra rice is not.
Ayan, nako ha, sa mga mahilig mag-extra rice dyan, alam nyo na, bawas tayo ng konti. Coach Anne, final message and final tips and advice na lang po sa ating mga kapabansa regarding losing weight and at the same time watching out for their health.
All right. Ayan. So, I hope yung mga tips and advice ko, it really helped you, especially the momshies out there, the fit momshies out there, and the entire, the mga Pilipino na rin. So, ang masasabi ko lang talaga is, self-love is not selfish. Dedicate a certain time for exercise for yourself. And at the same time, invest on proper food. Kasi the moment na inalagaan mo ang katawan mo, it's going to be much easier for you to take care and love other people. And especially if you really love your work, spend time for yourself, invest in good food that will fuel up your body para mag-function siya properly and efficiently. And of course, ang pinakamasasabi ko rin, coming from one of my greatest mentors also, si Jim Rohn, take care of your body because it's the only place you have to live. Yan. Kasi we only have one body and we have to, kumbaga, as much as possible, if you want to really achieve all the blessings, we always ask for good health, right? Kapag nag-birthday, nag-happy birthday ka, we always wish for that. Always remember, aside from wishing, you need to start doing it also.
Mm-hmm. Well said, Coach. Maraming salamat po for joining us this morning. And mag-iingat din po kayo. Mga kapamansa, nakapanayan po natin si Coach Anne Aniak of the Fit Mom Project PH. And hopefully, nakuha nyo yung mga tips and advice niya sa atin yan para naman ma-achieve na natin yung quarantine body na inaasam natin lahat.